Cognac region, 100 kilometers to the north of Bordeaux, covers an area of almost 80,000 hectares, a surface larger than the English county of Middlesex.
The Cognac region is blanketed by grapes, which, once harvested, will be fermented, then distilled in the onion-shaped Charente pot still. The distillation process concentrates the liquid, which explains why such a large area of vines is planted. However, the quality of the grapes produced will depend on where in the region they are planted. The best grapes come from Grand Champagne, a sub-region with similar chalky soils to those found in the Champagne region. Other sub-regions are Petit Champagne, Borderies, Fanbois, Bonbois, and Bois Ordinaire, in descending order of quality. After distillation, the clear spirit, or eau de vie, is run into oak casks to mature, a process which contributes to the majority of the flavor of the finished product. Cognacs have a distinct set of aging designations, the most common of which are VS, also known as 3-star, VSOP, and XO, indicating minimum time in oak of 2, 4, and 10 years respectively. The designation refers to the youngest cognac in the blend, which can be a combination of many individually matured eau de vie. One boutique cognac house which exclusively produces XO cognac is Maison Tesserand. Founded by Abel Tesserand, who acquired the property and began his collection of rare and priceless cognacs in the late 19th century. In 1905, he created his own cognac business, relying on two estates, one in Grand Champagne and one in Petit Champagne. He built up stocks of eau de vie, carefully conserved in this 12th century crypt.
Donc mon métier consiste à élever les cognacs dans les fûts et barriques et tonneaux et les cognacs qui sont issus de la distillation où nous trouvons maintenant. Voilà, donc après moi mon rôle est aussi de faire les différents assemblages en vue de produire nos différents lots qui deviendront nos cognacs dans les bouteilles tesserons. Donc le VS est un cognac qui a au minimum 2 ans de vieillissement dans les fûts de chêne. Le VSOP est un cognac qui a minimum 4 ans de vieillissement en fûts de chêne. Et le XO, c'est un vieillissement de 10 ans minimum en fûts de chêne. Sachant que nous ici, nous ne faisons uniquement que des XO qui ont un minimum de 10 ans et au-delà. Donc en fait, la distillation se passe en 2 étapes. La première étape, on met des vins dans les chaudières pour obtenir un premier liquide qu'on va appeler le brouillis, qui va titrer à peu près 30 degrés d'alcool. Et la deuxième étape, on va mettre le brouillis qu'on a obtenu lors de la première distillation dans les chaudières pour obtenir l'eau de vie qui, elle, va titrer environ 70 degrés d'alcool. Donc l'eau de vie de cognac, c'est un alcool qui est distillé, il va sortir limpide à la sortie des alambics, il va être transparent. Et pour le cognac, il est issu du raisin. Nous avons 3 cépages qui sont l'uniblanc, les folles blanches et les colombards, qu'on va élever après séparément. Et cette eau de vie se situe dans une appellation contrôlée, qui est l'appellation du cognac. Donc dans l'appellation cognac, où la majorité de l'encépagement est en uniblanc. Et après, il y a quelques autres cépages qui peuvent composer le cognac, dont les colombards et les folles blanches. Les folles blanches, nous sommes très peu en possédé, parce qu'elles sont très difficiles à obtenir de qualité au vignoble. La pourriture peut s'installer très vite et on peut perdre la récolte. Mais nous avons 5 hectares de folles blanches que nous pouvons suivre et dont nous pouvons intervenir lors des vendanges assez rapidement pour ne pas avoir de problème de pourriture sur ce cépage-là. C'est un cépage après qui procure des eaux de vie beaucoup plus fines et beaucoup plus parfumées. Voilà. Mais la difficulté au vignoble fait qu'on en voit très peu. Donc la pourriture que l'on a ici n'est pas du tout la même que celle qu'on peut trouver dans le Sauternes. C'est pas la pourriture noble, c'est une pourriture qui va impacter les grappes et impacter la qualité des graines de raisin. Et après, ça va se retrouver dans les eaux de vie. Parce qu'il faut savoir que la distillation, c'est une concentration d'arômes. Donc on va concentrer à la fois ce qui est très bon, mais on peut concentrer ce qui est mauvais si on a quelque chose qui n'est pas bon dès le départ. Donc on va accentuer le défaut s'il y a un défaut dans le vin. En fait, les assemblages sont successifs tout au long de l'élevage. C'est-à-dire que pour faire un cognac tel que le Lot 29 qui va avoir trois générations, on va commencer les premiers assemblages au bout, ça dépend de la qualité des eaux de vie, d'une dizaine, quinzaine d'années. Ça va être un premier assemblage. Et au fur et à mesure de l'élevage, suivant comment va se comporter l'eau de vie, comment elle va réagir aux premiers assemblages, on va encore l'assembler à d'autres eaux de vie. Et ça, sur une durée de 50, 60, 70 ans pour produire le Lot 29. Et c'est que la dégustation régulière qui va me permettre de déterminer à quel moment je vais faire l'assemblage. Il ne va pas y avoir de règles bien définies. C'est vraiment mes sens qui vont intervenir. Aujourd'hui, je détiens dans ma tête tout le stock. Voilà, et il y a très peu d'écrits, tout est dans ma tête. Et après, avec Monsieur Tesseron ou avec Noé Tesseron, on regarde les assemblages qui sont produits, voir si la qualité leur convient et si on est bien fidèle à l'image Tesseron. Et voilà, on valide les nouvelles coupes ainsi.
So we are a family-owned cognac house, and we've been producing cognac, actually distillating, aging, and blending eau de vie since now four generations. And it's a very, very small production. It's quite a niche boutique market, and we almost exclusively produce only XO cognac, which is 10 years minimum in barrel. And we are now in the Paradis, which is where we store those oldest eau de vie in 25 liters glass jars, which are called demi-johns. And it's quite a place where time stands very much still. So not only we've been producing cognac since several generations now, but we also own Château Pontécanet in Pauillac, as well as one property in Napa Valley called Pimeret-Tesson Estate. And we've had the chance to offer several vintages of Pontécanet on board at Emirates already. And you know, there's something that really comes from cognac, which is really family values, tradition, which is also, of course, applied at Pontécanet and Pimeret. And it is really a sense of wanting to offer the best juice, the best wine, the best cognac possible. It's really a sense of excellence that we strive to achieve at all those properties.
Whilst there are over 200 brands of cognac currently in production, the market is dominated by just seven. Of these, one stands head and shoulders above the others in its dominance of the market, Hennessy.
Founded by Richard Hennessy, an Irish officer serving in the army of Louis XV in 1765, the company expanded quickly, already exporting to the United States in 1794, when the country was just 18 years old.
In 1817, Hennessy created the style called VSOP, or Very Superior Old Pale, at the request of the Prince of Wales, later to be crowned King George IV. This was followed in 1865 by the three-star designation, also known as VS, and in 1870, XO, the original.
Both innovations of Maurice Hennessy, the great-grandson of the founder. By this time, exports had expanded to both China and Russia, where the imperial family had requested an exceptional cognac as a birthday present for Tsar Alexander I. In 2011, Hennessy, with master blenders Yann and Renaud Filloux, representing the 7th and 8th generation respectively, created the exceptional cognac Paradis Imperial, the jewel in the crown of the Hennessy collection. Emirates is proud to serve this rare blend of just 10 or so eau de vie selected from 10,000 on select routes as a supplement to Hennessy Paradis.
Emirates is the only airline to serve either Hennessy Paradis or Paradis Imperial.
I am a member of testing committee. It means I work with eight generations of master blender of the same family. It's a Renaud Filloux de Gironde. And every day, we are six members. We have to test 50, 60, 70 samples. Why to make the selection? Because it's a distillation of wine, so it's like a wine. Some of the vines have very good aromas, but have no potential to age long time, okay? And some of the vines need time to age very long time. So the selection is very important to know with the eau de vie what we are going to do. If we are going to use it to make a VS, or to make a XO, or to make a Paradis, or to make a Paradis Imperial. And we test every year 10,000 samples. Paradis is very special because Paradis was created in 1979 by Mr. Maurice Fillou, the sixth generation of Master Blender. And why? He decided to create a special blend because he was a music lover, and he decided to create a symphony, like a symphony. Yeah? And so the blend, it's a blend of, you have more than 100 eau de vie in the blend. And the eau de vie was selected by his grandfather, so some of them have more than 100 years old. You have around 100, it's a blend of around 100 eau de vie. We have in the testing committee to make exactly the same blend, the same color, the same nose, the same test. And at the beginning, the eau de vie selected are very specific to make this blend. Why? Because this blend, we age at the beginning in new cask from Limousin, very good. The selection is very important of a cask also. All is important. And the eau de vie are very round, very silky. At the beginning, so new cask, after you age in cask of 270 liters, cask of 10, 15 years old, and after 50 years, we age the eau de vie in a big cask, what we call Tirson here. It's a cask of around 580 liters. And so we have to be patient to make this blend. And thanks to the generation before, because they selected before all the eau de vie we can use today to make Paradis. Some of the vie come from the Funder cellar, so very old cellar, created in 1774. And the typicity of this blend is the spicy aromas, because you have some passion fruit, candied fruit, and you have some dried roses, you have honey, you have a lot of aromas. But a lot of fruit and only the thyme can give this aromas, okay? So you have to be really passionate. Paradis Imperial, it's a very special blend created 9 years ago by Mr. Yann Fillou, second generation of Master Blender. And Mr. Yann Fillou decided to create the most elegant blend possible with the stock selected by his predecessor. So, with a testing committee, he decided to create a special blend. And the eau de vie are really different. Why? Because, imagine, when we test 10,000 eau de vie every year, only 10 on 10,000 have the potential to make Paradis Imperial. And these eau de vie are really, really the top. Only the expertise in the testing committee can find the good eau de vie, and then we have to follow and take care of the evolution. So, we never at the beginning put the eau de vie in new cask to preserve the flowers almost. If I give you a secret, if you put in a new cask, you will have more roundness, but more spicy notes, okay, after aging. If we don't, you don't put in new cask, if you put in what we call a red cask, it's a cask at the beginning of 8-10 years old, you will preserve all the aromas of eau de vie, the flowers aromas. So, in the blend, you have 120 eau de vie. Some of them have around 130 years old. VS have a lot of success everywhere in the world. Why? Because it's an easy cognac to understand at the beginning, to learn the cognac, to understand the cognac. Why? This is the youngest quality. By law, VS, it's minimum 2 years old in cask. But for Hennessy, we use eau de vie from 5, 8 years old. Why? Because it's impossible to make a blend with 2 years old only. Because it's too strong. And what makes the success of Hennessy, it's the roundness of this blend. Because it's very round, very easy to understand. And in this blend, if you smell it, you smell the fruit of a grape after distillation, of course. And you smell red almonds, for example. And of course, we have a lot of work. We take care. And we take care of this blend in the tasting committee because it's you have to start with VBS when you don't know cognac. So it's, for me, one of the most important to start.
Across all three classes, cognac is a staple of Emirates Spirits offering. This profound and complex spirit is perfect to relax with, meditate over, and enjoy as Emirates transports you smoothly to your destination. We return to Bordeaux for our next stop and visit the sweet wine-producing region of Sauternes. Join us there on the Emirates Wine Channel.